Not much further now.
But we're in the middle of the Deadlands.
Keen eye, you. The blight sucked this place dry. Meaning no trees, no birds, and no magic. But it also means no neighbors.
The last place anyone would think to look.
Home sweet home.
This place. These are fallen ruins.
Well, we didn't think they'd mind. And it keeps the black from our lungs.
But how do you survive without magic?
How does anyone? Hard work and a bit of nous. You must be starving. We grow them here, believe it or not. Suit yourself.
You're back.
Ah, Talia.
And this is the Dominant.
How cold since we found her. I was hoping you might give her a look over.
All right. Goots, get her upstairs.
But none will...
Don't fret about Karen. I've taken care of her fee.
All of it.
She's the best healer this side of the belt. You've nothing to worry about. Go on. Have a look around. I'll be in my solar.
Still hungry, are you? Might have something round here.
Another newcomer. You mind the rules round here, or our next chat will be through the bars.
Washroom floor's all mended then.
It'll hold for now.
I suppose I'll be needing a new sword.
Then you'll need to speak with Blackthorn.
Sid once told me, the Blight doesn't kill the land, it only makes her forget who she once was. She'll eventually remember her purpose. All she needs is a little reminding.
Your brand. Lady Tyre might be able to see to that. You may have been born a slave, but you're a free man now.
Leave me be.
Not until you've had your medicine.
You went without? You reckon he's a soldier then?
Be surprised if he wasn't. The smell of war is thick about him.
He'd have time for a nip with old August before scampering back to his solar, but no.
Lonely, are we, August?
When lightning struck his yoke did break, his life his own again. With thunder's roll, he knew his fate and would fight it to the end. What do you think? I woke this morn inspired.
When he's not out chasing rumors, sits up there in that hole of his, brooding and scheming.
Lay off the man. He's got plenty to brood about.
I'm not going back to that life. Ever. You hear me?
Oh, great. Even if it means never seeing the sun again.
If you can read, don't let Otto know. We'll put you to work on the ledgers too.
Working on a pet project of mine. Though she's not above biting the hand that feeds her. All right. I was hoping we might try and solve the mystery of poor Clive Rossfield, a bearer of the Sambrequois Imperial Army sent behind enemy lines, with orders to wait until it turned into a brawl, then slit the dominant's throat in the chaos.
I didn't know it was her. How could it be?
And so, to save her neck, you slit your sergeants, then set your sights on the hills, conveniently forgetting how the Empire deals with deserters. Because with that on your chop, my friend, we both know you won't be getting far. You've fallen a long way, Lord Rossfield. I'll not have it said that I'm a poor host.
What do you mean to do with her?
Do with her? Why, nothing. Her life is her own now. If I wanted to use her, do you think I'd be talking to you? All I want to do is help. Dominance like her, branded like you. Of course, the realm doesn't approve, which is why we live in a cave. And it's also why we need help. From branded who know one end of a sword from the other. What say you, Clive? Will you join us?
Sid, was it? I trust that you'll do right by Jill. But until my brother is avenged, I must walk my own path.
Avenged.
My brother was murdered by a second dominant of fire.
The Phoenix is evil twin. Oh, bugger me. Another rumor proven true.
I only stand here today because of Joshua. 13 years I've waited for this chance. I've slept in filth, drunk from a gutter, killed more men than I can count. You're right. The Empire will not suffer a deserter. This will be my best opportunity. My last.
Which is why you should join us.
I told you I'm not...
interested, I know. One of my scouts sent word there's a group of branded fugitives north of here, in the Imperial village of Lost Wing. Among them is one he believes to be a dominant of fire.
Is he certain?
What say we go and ask him?
This doesn't mean I'm joining you.
Let's make ready then. You'll find everything you need down in the main hall, as well as a few things you don't. Have fun. It's downstairs. Try not to get lost.
Was it? Perhaps you can help.
Sid asked me to make ready for our mission. How does one go about that here?
There's old Nan's place. On second thoughts, you maybe want to see Blackthorn first.
A blacksmith? To the forge it is, then.
Oh, wait! No! Hold up! You'll be needing this. Blackthorn won't take no notice of you otherwise.
Might not anyway.
The forge is down the end. Just follow the sound of Blackthorn's hammer.
Fancy a mug of Kenneth Coldus when we're done.
Does Titan ship boulders?
Are you Blackthorn?
What if I am? I've no time for idle chatter.
I'm not here to talk. I'll be accompanying Sid to Lost Wing and I need you to see to my equipment.
You could be accompanying the goddess Grieger to her holy bedchamber for all I care. I'm not lifting a finger for you.
Is that so? Do you want that or not? I can take it back.
No. Damn you, Coots. All right. No need to be hasty. Let's have a look at you. I doubt that lot could stay a Moogle's fart. Bloody Imperials. They'd rather see their bearers dead than kit it out properly. I'll do what I can, as a favor to Goot's mind. Caesar Square. You want anything else? You bring your own materials.
I'll bear that in mind. Thank you.
A word of advice. Don't let Sid decide what's best for you.
I suppose I should thank Goots.
Make it quick. But I ain't the cook, am I? Look. You got anything needs repairing? So, what'll it be? Anything else?
The gift worked. You have my thanks.
Come on, nearly there. You, blankets, quick as you like. Making comfortable while the bed's made up. Well, you're just gonna stand there. Someone fetch some water.
I'll get the bucket. You go and see if Otto needs out, eh?
Wait, me? What the hell have I got myself into? Who are they?
Huh? They're freed Imperial bearers. Who the hell are you? Shit, at this rate, you won't make it through the night. Think you can find your way up them stairs to the infirmary? We need Tyre. Well, go on. Shift your ass.
Was Tyre the one looking after Jill?
Top of the stairs, first door on your right. Quick!
What's all the
Do you think
motion?
We should go and help?
Looks like we've got some
it
new
sounds
customers.
Like Otto has everything.
Careful, you. I've spent the whole morning on these steps.
Your friend needs her rest. There'll be time for tearful reunions once she's recovered.
I'm not here for Jill. You're wanted downstairs. There are injured bearers in need of attention.
Well, why didn't you say so?
I did say so.
He's going to be all right, but I'll need to examine them both in the infirmary. My work's just begun.
Another fine day at the Hideaway.
Do many of the bearers who come here arrive in this state?
It's no easy thing, casting off your chains. By the time most pluck up the courage, they're already too far gone. These two here are the lucky ones. The name's Otto. You need anything, you ask me.
Well, Otto, I do need some supplies.
Do you now? Then Lady Karen over there will be more than happy to help you.
Right.
Oh, and thanks. Be seeing you.
Not likely. I won't be staying.
Is that right? Well, for as long as you are here, consider yourself welcome. You helped us today, and we won't forget it.
People. I need supplies for my journey to Lost Wing. Otto said you could provide them.
What's that? Does the newcomer think it proper to make demands of a poor old matron before even introducing himself?
It's Clive.
Well, Clive, I hear that dog is yours. Since he followed Sid home one night, I've seen to it that his chin's rubbed and his belly fed. Though I suppose that's your job now. Unless you lose him again.
I won't. Not again. Thank you for watching him.
So, were you going to buy something? What? You didn't think I'd shower your lordship with my hard-won wares while you swagger about with a pocket full of gil? Life doesn't work that way, lad. Now, let's see some coin. You're rubbing me blind, you know.
That's all.
Why, you're barely a guilt to your name. You're taking his side now. And after all I've done for you. All right. All right, I can make an exception. But just this once, mind. My stores are getting cluttered and I need to make room for the next shipment.
Thank you.
Thank me?
Thank your dog.
Thank you.
You all done?
Leaving already, are you?
It's you I'll miss the most, Lady Karen. It always is.
Doesn't stop you going, does it?
This should be fun.
Right.
We should go and help.
It sounds like Otto has everything under control, as always.
Don't think I haven't noticed you stealing sips from that pot.
Sid can take some getting used to, but his heart's in the right place. Give him a chance.
A new face, and, dare I hope, a willing pair of hands. The fat chocobo is a demanding mistress, and we are too few to keep her on her feet. Might I persuade you to deliver a meal or two to souls in need of sustenance? For your trouble, I can offer you the contents of my strongbox and my enduring gratitude.
I don't see why not.
Marvelous. And who exactly do I have the honor of addressing?
Clive.
Delighted to make your acquaintance, Clive. I'm Kenneth, and mine are the weary shoulders upon which the weight of this fine establishment rests. Now, I have three hungry customers awaiting their victuals. Take these if you would, and be careful. They're hot.
Has it been? Your food.
I was hoping it might be. Well, doesn't this look fine? Thank you, lad. You're new, aren't you? Kenneth's running you ragged already, I expect, the old rascal.
Well, he did say he'd give me something for my trouble.
And so he should. We're not slaves anymore. Well met, lad. And keep up the good work. It's nice to see the Hideaway finally coming alive. Wasn't so long ago us old hands were rattling about the place like peas in a bucket.
Yeah.
Oh, my thanks. I hope you do not think me lazy for waiting to be served like a lord. Only my former master did not use me kindly, you see. He left me half lame, truth be told. But Sid took me in nonetheless. Oh, the Hideaway is the home I never knew, and a mighty fine one at that. I'd been cast out and left for dead when Sid found me. There's not a day goes by I don't count my blessings.
The Iron Blood were quick to sound the retreat once Titan turned up.
Fat lot of good that icon of theirs did.
So much more to farming than just seeds and soil.
Your food.
Just a moment. I need to finish this. I won't be a burden. I'm of no use to anyone as I am, but maybe if I can master this.
All right, but see that you eat it before it gets cold.
Of course. Thank you.
That's the last one. I'd better let Kenneth know.
Yours is not a familiar face. Are you new to the Hideaway, perchance?
You could say that.
Well then, allow me to welcome you. I am Harpocrates II Hyperboreus.
That's quite
a mouthful, I know. Which is why everyone here has taken to calling me simply Tones, on account of the company I keep. And what varied company. I'm a collector, you see. Not of bijou and baubles, but of stories. The history and culture of these isles have ever been a source of endless fascination to me. But alas, my days of wandering the realm in search of new tales are far behind me. And so I've taken to sharing that which I've gathered with all who might listen. Perhaps you would care to listen. When I was very young, yet, when I arrived, fortunately, I
don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. I have a few new notes that might interest you. You wish to study the tomes? always welcome, Clive.
The dung had so many uses. All done, I presume? Splendid.
They were bearers. All three of them. Not slaves waiting upon their master's pleasure, but men waiting to be fed like equals.
Indeed. Equality is the very cornerstone upon which our little community is founded. Beyond these walls, we are scorned as slaves. Speaking only when spoken to, eating only what scraps our masters deign to give us. The first hot meal here is the first many will have known. In the Hideaway, we are free. Truly free to speak as we please, when we please, and to eat what and when we desire. More than reason enough to trust in Cid's vision, wouldn't you say? Now, I promised you something for your trouble, did I not? The contents of my strongbox are yours to do with as you will. Thank you, Clive. Do come and visit me again, won't you?
We should go and help.
It sounds like Otto has everything under control.
As always.
Where to next?
For now, we rest and regroup. There are far too few of us as it is, and I won't risk losing anyone through lack of preparation.
I heard they escaped.
Masters in the Imperial Capital. By the look of those bruises. Not a moment too soon.
It doesn't matter where they came.
You another one of Cid's strays? What? We all are. Little uns, big uns, and everything in between. We're a damn sight better off here than out there in the world.
Is falling apart.
Damn it.
We'll be needing more wood. But if I step away to fetch any, this lot will be down around our ears.
Ah, you there. Perfect timing. I couldn't persuade you to fetch me some timber, could I?
I'd be happy to.
Oh, thank you. You'll be helping me and the Hideaway both. Takes a lot of work to keep this place standing. More than we can manage, if I'm honest.
It certainly looks like you've got your hands full.
You can say that again. The Fallen knew their craft, make no mistake, but not even their handiwork lasts forever. That's why the walls need shoring up. Can't have the vegetable patch crushed before our first harvest now, can we?
No, I suppose not. All right, where can I find this wood?
Ask over at the White Ads. They'll point you in the right direction. Thanks again. I really appreciate the help.
Excuse me. The man working over by the garden sent me to fetch some wood.
Ah, that'll be Geoffrey, Master Carpenter.
Luck would have it, we've just finished cutting the timber he's after. You take as much as you need from the stack.
Thank you.
No, not at all. We appreciate the assistance. All the wood you're likely to need is piled up just over there, ready for Master Jeffrey.
Here we are. I better get this to Jeffrey, was it?
You're leaving? Already? Well, stay safe.
Sid once told me, the Blight doesn't kill the land, it only makes her forget who she once was.
Oh, you're back. Hope fetching that wood wasn't too much trouble.
Will this be enough?
This will do nicely, thank you. With a bit of luck, the walls won't be falling in on us just yet.
That sounds ominous.
It's not as bad as all that. And it's a damn sight better than the alternative. We're safe, we're warm, and we're hidden. What more could we ask for? Now stop fretting and take this. You've earned it. Welcome to the fold.
There's no need to...
That's not a matter of need, my friend. You're one of us now. This should be enough to shore things up for a little while yet. Thanks again.
There's a good girl. Hungry, are you?